If you've ever received a sketchy PDF or image, which is probably everybody watching this video, whether it was on a messenger or an email or just some person that you thought you could trust, this is the video for you. In the security community, we talk a lot about best practice. And what that typically means is don't open malicious attachments, just be good, be well educated. And these are all good things in theory. But when it comes down to it, a lot of times you need to actually open an attachment to see if it's legitimate. This tool, Dangerzone, is how you can safely open anything. Now, before I get into the demo and show you exactly how it works, it's important to have a bit of context behind the tool. So this is actually designed by someone who has a lot of experience with journalists, which is Micah Lee. You might know Micah Lee as the developer of OnionShare, which is another tool I've done a tutorial on this channel, but he also does Dangerzone. Now, this makes a lot of sense from a journalist's perspective. As it says here, it's your job to open documents from strangers wherever you get them, and it's your job to see if they're legitimate or not, which is kind of a tough spot to put journalists because they have to open those things, which could get them hacked. But you all are really in the same situation whether or not you're a journalist, because a lot of times you need to open something to see if it's legitimate. Now, PDFs especially are really bad for this kind of thing because they can have a lot of embedded stuff that can hack you very easily, and so it's very important to avoid those. But we find attacks like this in PNGs, images, SVGs. There are all kinds of attachments that you can receive that can all be malicious. What Dangerzone does is it takes these attachments, it opens them, and it's a sandboxed environment away from your operating system, and then it creates a visual representation of the document that's essentially like a preview of the document. So you get what looks identical, but it's not the actual file. And then it gives you a document that even if the first one had malware and was trying to hack you, the new one would. Of course, you can still get hacked with this. It's not a foolproof tool, but I can very fairly say this will add a huge amount of security out there for anybody who has been in this situation. It's all open source. You can check it out. It is still active. They pushed out an update a few months ago, and you can see some things that were done even a few weeks ago. And without further ado, let's actually dive into the tool. So it's free to download, and you can see it's available on Linux, it's available on Windows, macOS, and even Cubes. All production stuff back here is done on macOS, if you guys haven't been able to tell from the video demos. So I'm gonna go ahead and demo on that, but it's the same program on all of these things. Now, while we're installing this, it's important for me to mention that this doesn't just work with PDFs. It actually works with countless file types, including image file types, documents like Microsoft Office documents, and of course, PDFs. But pretty much anything can be put through this that's on its officially supported documentation. So we can go ahead and open Dangerzone. Now, when you open it, you are going to be told that it requires Docker. Now, Docker might look confusing. What it is it's essentially a lightweight virtual machine software that makes it very easy to self-host things. So normally, I'd say this is not something I'd recommend to people who are new to this kind of thing, but I promise you it's super easy to set up as someone who also doesn't love to use Docker. So I went ahead and just installed Docker. I dragged it into the applications, and now Docker is opening. And that should be all you need to do. You just click check again, and then it installs the container image for you. So all this is really doing, Dangerzone, is automating the process of setting up your own Docker container that would otherwise do all this stuff automatically. And with all that done, like I said, literally all you have to do is just install Docker. You don't really have to know how to use Docker very well, but you see it's done. So I went ahead and just selected a document. You can drag a document in, or you can use the tool that lets you use your file explorer. I recently gave a remote talk at EFF Austin, which was a lot of fun, and I had to build a PowerPoint, which was a PDF, so I'm gonna use that as my demo for this. I recommend using the default here, move original documents to unsafe subdirectory, so that way you can better compartmentalize things that are safe and unsafe, and then you can open the safe documents after converting. And the OCR document language should be whatever the language of the document is. So then you just do convert to safe document, and you're going to see it's going to do the magic here. It's doing something in Docker, but we don't need to know what it is because this is meant for anybody to use. And then it goes ahead and opens the document. And you might be looking and it's like, well, it just looks like a document. And that's exactly why Dangerzone is so beautiful, because it, in the background, what it did is it opened the document in the sandbox. That's what's happening here in Docker. Docker is essentially the sandbox. And then it goes ahead and processes that, converts it into a safe document, and now it is here. So if someone sent me a malicious version of my PowerPoint and it was on my computer, most likely there's nothing that it can do until I actually opened the program. And so if there was some malicious thing in that PowerPoint, I could just drag it into Dangerzone, but Dangerzone will give me a safe version of the PowerPoint. And this is a wonderful tool for any of you. This is great if you're checking emails and someone sends you something that you're like, I don't know if this is trustworthy or not. Let me run it through Dangerzone instead of needing to boot up an entire virtual machine, which yes, is another option, but this should give you the same kind of protection. And it's literally just built for this to make it super convenient. You saw how that took like 30 seconds. And once you got used to using it, I guarantee you, you can get it in under 30 seconds. Some limitations to be aware of. This won't support every document in the world, but pretty much every common document you'll likely receive that you're concerned about should probably work in Dangerzone. I'm sure there are some weird situations where it can't fully process certain documents. I haven't confirmed every edge case and every weird file format and people doing weird things to documents. Even they say that it's still possible some kind of attack could get through Docker. Again, even though Docker is sandbox and it's essentially running like almost a virtual machine, that's the easiest way for me to explain what Docker is doing for all of you. It could still theoretically bypass the Docker container, but these are very, 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 very unlikely scenarios. Most people are just sending these malicious PDFs to everyone they can and just hoping that some sucker opens it. And we just don't want that sucker to be you. And Dangerzone is a great tool to do that. In fact, it is so easy that once you set it up for someone, I bet you can even get your parents, your grandparents, your family members, and friends to use it, which would keep everyone in your life a little bit safer. And of course, it's all free and it's open source, so there's really nothing to complain about. If you like Dangerzone, check it out on their website. I'll try to leave a link in the description as well. If you like this tutorial, definitely consider supporting us here at Techlore. A lot of this stuff is very fun to do and educate you guys on, and Dangerzone is not one I've seen discussed enough in the community, despite it being probably one of the most important tools you should be using, because everyone receives malicious things that they don't know whether or not they should open, and I feel like this is a great way to give you that peace of mind without the complexity of using virtual machines. So check it out. Thank you, Micah, for building a cool tool. Thank you, the open source community. And I'll see you next time on Techlore. Again, don't forget to try to support us down below if you can. See you next time.